quit saving it. You're here and you're praying. You feel God has forgiven you. You feel like you want to come and share that with us. We would be more than glad.
Yeah.
See you come. I love what I've heard this morning, Brother Darrell. Not only what I've heard, but I've felt.
Yeah.
From the beginning of this service till now.
Yeah.
And I hope and pray that He keeps blessing.
Yeah.
That we'll do the will of God and see what God does. He'll do His part.
Yes, He will.
If we will do ours, that's the problem. So I hear these brothers talk and tell of people of this book and of their own experiences. It overwhelmed my heart.
Yeah.
And the fountain of my eyes opened and tears began to flow. I felt that this morning.
Yeah.
And that's a wonderful feeling, wonderful feeling. You say, well, Randy, I don't cry. I thank God for my tears.
Yeah.
It's not tears of sorrow. It's tears of joy. Yeah, because I know that someday this physical life that you see and this body that you see has to go back to the ground which you come from.
Yeah.
There's a part of me, Brother Bobby, that will live forever.
Yeah.
Oh, that hidden man of the heart. You say, well, I don't see that. No, you don't see it. But the evidence of that in there has to come to the surface.
Yeah.
Every now and then. My prayer is, oh God, I want to go to heaven more than anything in this world. I want to see men and women go. Because I believe with all my heart that the jury, this is a real thing.
Yeah, it is.
More real this morning than what we are. And listen, He's a precious Savior. Oh, He is a precious Savior to the believer this morning.
Yeah.
I recall being a young boy of 19 years old, Brother Larry, listen, standing on the side of a riverbank, watching my brother and his wife being baptized, and God, oh, dealing with my heart. And I thought He was going to come out with me, Brother Bob. And I've often likened that unto a certain old prophet of God, listen, that wrestled with God all night long. And the angel began to say to him, let me go before the sun rises. He said, I'll not let you go until you bless me. Oh, friendless son, I got a little touch of something I didn't want to let go of that. Oh, listen, as I said last night, it was like that. He put the hook in my jaw, and He was drawing me to a different place, Brother Lesson. And I'm glad that, like the old fisherman, he landed me. I listen in the boat, Brother Darrell. Listen, friend, I want to say to you this morning, if you don't know Him, there's no better time than this. I'm wanting to get acquainted with Him because He said like this. He said, today is a day of salvation. Now is this suitable time. Harden not your heart. If you believe in me, you shall not perish, Brother Lesson. I love the Lord this morning, and the thoughts that I had on my mind was an old Baptist, a soul. I found him real to my soul. He didn't solve every problem that Randy has in his life. And most of the problems I have in this life, Randy has caused. It ain't been God. I couldn't blame the God. And I know this. He loves me and he loves you. And it's his good pleasure to give you heaven. He wants you to go more than anything in this world. And I want you to go. Why? Because God has placed in me that kind of love.